welcome to Enots Engineering. I'm Alan. A few weeks ago, I did a review on a digital height gauge, and one of the comments I had was that they are okay, but difficult to adjust to a certain size. So today, I'm going to try and make a fine adjuster for a digital height gauge, or even a digital caliper of the same type. So let's go into the workshop, see how we do it. This is the material I'm using. It's a sheet of nylon, and it was originally a chopping board for kitchen use. I'm machining a groove here to fit the caliper into. So I'm just cutting a slot in there. It's about 16 millimetres wide and 5 millimetres deep. It needs to be a nice slide fit on the caliper. I've cut the slot deeper and I've changed the end mill for a 6mm end mill. And what I need to do is cut a slot going across. I've turned the piece up on its end, and now I need to centre drill the position for a 3mm hole. I've now changed to a 3mm drill and I'll drill straight through. I've just sawn it to length with the hacksaw, and now I'll just square it off with an end mill. This is the block so far. We've got a slot for the caliper to fit in, a slot there for a piece of brass for the nut, and then a hole, 3mm hole, right the way through. So the caliper fits in there. The hole in the end aligns with the wheel on the caliper. And now we'll make the brass fittings. I've just fitted my 3mm die in the die stock, and now we'll cut the thread. So you're going to let go of the handle. The die in the holder rotates. When I put some pressure on the handle, the die locks up and cuts. So I can reverse that. Yes. changed over to my knurling tool and I'm just cutting a straight knurl on the end. I'm now making the nut that goes onto the screw we've just made. I'm tapping an M3 thread. This is the finished screw and nut. I'll file the flat on this shaft here. Then on the block, just take the corner off. This is how it assembles. All I need to do is drill and tap a hole through here to clamp it to the digital caliper or height gauge, and drill and tap a hole in here to stop the spindle turning. I'm drilling two holes for the clamping screws. These will be tapped M3. I'm now putting the threads on the clamping screws.
This is the assembly. At the top we have two locking screws that clamp the part to the caliper. This is the adjusting screw and the adjusting nut. You can see I've put the flat on this screw long enough so it just goes into the slot. For the assembly, the adjusting screw goes through and the nut, adjusting nut, goes in the centre and you screw the two parts together. You can screw that through using the knurled part on the end of the screw until it comes out the other end. Once the adjusting screw is fully home to the face, just make sure that the flat is facing the locking screw and then lock the screw. And that stops the screw from turning when you adjust the nut. Don't tighten it too tight. The screw still needs to move in and out when you turn the adjusting nut. As you turn the adjusting nut, it's pushing the screw out or in, whichever way you turn the nut. So how does this work? It fits on your digital caliper or on your digital height gauge with the same sort of caliper. I've put two locking screws on because if you over tighten one, you could strip the thread. So I'll put two on. Then to adjust the size, all you do, turn the nut and then the rod should come in and push the caliper along to whatever size you need. You can adjust it by 0.01 of a millimetre. It should have about 5 mil of travel, so you need to clamp it up on the caliper within 5 mil of the size you want. By turning this screw, you can adjust the size till you get the size you want. And then lock the caliper when it's reached the size. And this will fit this type of caliper and also the digital height gauge that has a similar caliper on it. Well, that's it for today. Hope that's useful. Hope it was interesting. And we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.